Hard drives often have to be formatted to work on MacBooks and Apple desktops, but I definitely had some difficulty getting this Windows NTFS formatted Western Digital drive to work on my MacBook. The good news is that I just figured out how to get this to work, and I'll show you how to fix this on your own computer by the end of this video. This Western Digital drive is Windows NTFS formatted and is not Mac friendly, so the first thing I did was try to simply format it. But that resulted in an error saying MediaKit reports not enough space on device for requested operation. So I was confused on how there's not enough space. This is a 1 terabyte drive and I kept getting that error every time I tried to format it. I tried some other stuff and eventually got a message saying that the disk was unreadable and it needs to be initialized. And this is the point where we can start to fix the problem. Clicking on initialize takes me to the disk utility, which is exactly where we want to be. You can also get to the disk utility by clicking on the launch pad and then on other. You'll find the disk utility here. I'll click and highlight the external drive I just plugged in here in the left column. Now go to the top menu and click on View, and then on Show All Devices. That will expand the drive list on the left. First thing to do is click on the Eject button next to the name of your drive. Now I'll click on my drive, which is WD Elements in the list. The name of your drive might be different depending on the brand you're using. Now click on the Erase button in the middle. In this window, we can name the drive or leave it as untitled. I'll just type in a quick name here so I can confirm my changes later. On the next two drop-down menus, make sure the format is Mac OS Extended Journaled. For Scheme, make sure that it says GUID Partition Map. Now click the Erase button. Since this is a brand new drive, the formatting process only took a few seconds. And when it's done, this Time Machine window will pop up. I'll just cancel it at this point. Now I have the green check mark and can confirm that the formatting was successful. Just click Done and we're finished. And here on the desktop, I can see that the drive I just formatted and named is properly mounted on my MacBook and is ready for use. I'll just drag a couple files on here so you can see that it's working. I know computer problems can be frustrating, but I hope this video helped you with your MacBook or your Apple desktop. Please hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you won't miss any of my weekly videos. Thanks for watching.